first. It's game on in the United States. Super Tuesday turned into a Super Trump Day. Donald Trump is now officially running unopposed to be the Republican presidential nominee after rival Nikki Haley dropped out of the race.
They call it Super Tuesday for a reason. This is a big one. They tell me, the pundits and otherwise, that there's never been one like this. There's never been anything so conclusive.
A Trump versus Biden rematch seems inevitable. It's a big comeback, and it begs the question, how can a man accused of sparking an insurrection with multiple criminal cases and a literal mugshot hanging over his head still be popular enough to smash the Republican primaries? Is it a fluke? A bizarre stroke of luck or something more calculated? Our next question for the jury, is Trump a political genius? Joining me is James Morrow, US report and outsiders host here at Sky News Australia, who says yes, and he's up against Stephen Loosley, former Labor senator and fellow at the United States Study Centre. Hello to both of you. Thanks for joining us on the program this evening. James, how has Trump gotten this far? Is he a campaign mastermind? What is it?
Well, I think the thing, Danica, that you need to understand about Trump is that there's something about him that triggers his enemies so much that they wind up going to such wild extremes to stop him that it helps him. And just to pick up on one thing you said in your introduction, you know, you talked about those court cases. Well, you know, an awful lot of those court cases are nakedly political attempts. And I think Americans look at this and they say, come on, you're trying to get somebody on a fraud charge for taking out loans and paying them back? This is politics. This is not the American way.
Right. OK, well, that's an interesting point. Stephen, what do you think about that? Why don't you think he's a political genius, despite, as we've just said, all these criminal cases?
James would be on stronger ground if he was arguing that Homer Simpson should be recommended for the Nobel Peace Prize for physics. I mean, Trump is no genius by any stretch of the imagination, by any criteria. For a start, if he were a political genius, he would have won a second term. He would have beaten Joe Biden last time around. As it is, he's now bracketed with the first-term presidents such as Herbert Hoover or Jimmy Carter. And that clearly is a case of mediocrity. It's easy for the Trump NZ position to say that the charges against him, 91 of them, by the way, across multiple jurisdictions, state and federal, are politically driven. If you look at them, there's no way that Jack Smith, as the special prosecutor for the Department of Justice, is politically driven.
What do you think about that, James?
No, I mean, look, without getting into the weeds of these cases, and I'm sorry, Stephen, these are political cases. Letitia James, the Attorney General of the New York State, ran for office. You run for office in the states for Attorney General. And she said in speeches, we're going to go get Trump. Vote for me and we'll get Trump. And what did she do? They brought a case where they said that his 100-room club in Florida was not worth what he said to the banks, and therefore this was fraud. But, you know, on the question of his political
acumen...
Well,
can you also argue that the New York judiciary is politically driven?
It is.
Well, that is an extraordinary circumstance which will be overturned on appeal. There's no question about that.
So, you know, these are the same. We've seen these cases, the Colorado case.
You didn't want to get into the weeds, but you are actually deep in the weeds already.
Well, no, I'm afraid not, because, you know, the other things that he's done is he's realigned, I think, the Republican Party from being the party of, you know, big business, country club, capital, to being a party that's looking after working Americans. He called time on the, you know, the globalist free trade agenda, which was shipping jobs overseas from NAFTA onwards, and both parties were into that. He's the only one who wants to secure the southern border. You've got Joe Biden out there just hours ago apologizing for calling somebody illegal.
It is Trump's insistence on the current Speaker of the United States House of Representatives that the bill that was agreed in the United States Senate on a bipartisan basis with Senator James Lankford, a Republican of Oklahoma, very prominent in the heavy lifting, that would have addressed the border crisis, which needs to be addressed. It's Trump's pressure on the Republicans in the United States House of Representatives that stopped that bill even appearing before the House, and you turn it around
that
and say somebody
Steve,
else
I'm
is
sorry,
responsible?
That bill very quickly would not do anything to actually stop people coming across. It would only process them into the system
quickly.
All right,
let's get some jury feedback. Mitch in the front row, do you think that Trump is a political genius?
The first time he ran for political office, he was able to win the highest office in the land without any experience. Mm-hmm. Like, the number of times we've heard people say, it's over for Trump, there's no way he can win, and he's proven them wrong time and time again. And I suspect he's going to do the same in November.
OK, Steve, do you think that Trump's a political genius?
I think you've got to categorise the genius part first, because there's no doubt that the choices for the American public are pretty limited at the moment between someone who's quite clearly senile and frail and a very arrogant man who's, because of his business background, is going about politics in a completely different way. But that is his genius.
Yeah.
And I think that he may very well be successful in this election because he appeals to a large number of the masses.
Pamela, do you think he's a political genius?
Even though he's a billionaire, he relates so well to the everyday American person. And he understands their issues and he addresses them and gives them what they want.
Yeah.
Yes.
What about Arthur next to you there?
I definitely don't think he's a political genius, but he is a master manipulator.
Right.
And pretty good snake oil salesman. So, and a lot of people buy that. So, he's pretty good at those areas.
That's great. James, get your response to that. It's quite a snake.
It's an interesting thing there. People, you know, look at him, and because he's got that kind of property developer sort of... well, he was a property developer. I mean, you know, I think it's in the audience, property developers, we all have some thoughts on that. But you know, of course, there's an attitude, a way that he does things that is so different to the formal political language. But that's, again, I think that's where the cut-through is.
Yeah.
And, you know, obviously there's, you know, I'm not going to say... that, you know, you defend his character on everything, you might not want him to look after your houseplants. But, you know, in terms of the question here, is he a political genius? You know, I'm sorry, but he has changed the game for American politics, I think, forever, and reconnected politics to the people.
Right, well, Stephen, but how can you argue with that? You can't deny, though, that he's really made an art out of political survival.
Well, he's brought his period as an Atlantic City wrestling promoter into the political arena. He knows how to cut through, and he taps into... that grievance. I mean, it's a little bit like the Seinfeld episode where George Costanza's father introduces the notion of Festivus. There's always a grievance.
But, Stephen,
is there a grievance that
people should have?
The simple fact of the matter is Trump inherited a lot of money from his father and he built his real estate holdings on that. What the court cases are showing...
is that
a lot of Trump's confected imagery is just that.
All right. Justin.
But very quickly, though, this idea that, you know, he talks about playing into grievance, you know, look at the America that people were inheriting in 2016, you know, the shipping of jobs overseas, migration crises, other things. Shouldn't people feel a sense of grievance?
We've got to wrap it up. Unfortunately, we've run out of time. We could go on for ages with this. This is a great debate. We love talking about Trump. You've both had your say. It is time to call on the jury. Jurors, you have 10 seconds to deliberate. The following question: is Trump a political genius? Okay, time is up. What is the jury's verdict? Four no's. The rest of you believe that, yes, indeed, Donald Trump is a political genius. Rob,
yes.
Why yes?
The runs are on the board, I must admit. And I think his genius is the fact that he's a politician who's not a politician. He has no filter. What he thinks, he says. It could be 3 o'clock in the morning and he's...
Well, we know that. He likes that.
And people resonate with that. I was in the States in 2019 and I was asking everybody, why do you like him? He's rich. He's not for you. He's not religious. Why does the common man like him? Yeah. And he says... Every answer I got, he sticks up for us. He's sticking it to the liberal elites.
Yeah.
They believe that he's their man against the wokeness.
Well, that's what Pamela was saying earlier as well.
That's why.
Arthur, you're still maintaining that he's absolutely not a political genius.
Definitely not. Yeah. But he's a good salesman.
Yeah.
I'll give him that. And the American people, or half of them, buy it.
People Absolutely. Do buy it. Is that
of
what
Of course. He's currently leading in the polls. So obviously he's doing something right.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.